As sports psychologists, one of our key goals is to help athletes improve their performance. One common way to try and improve performance is to help athletes change what they think or how they feel. This approach is based on meta-analyses that show athletes tend to perform better when they're feeling good, feeling confident, and feeling relaxed in correlational studies. Interventions that aim to help improve performance by changing these thoughts and feelings are called content-focused approaches because they change the content of a person's internal experiences. For example, athletes might use progressive muscle relaxation to try to reduce their anxiety, or motivational self-talk to improve their confidence, saying things like, "I can do it." Yes, we'd like to improve mood, build confidence, and reduce anxiety for their own sake. But to our knowledge, only one meta-analysis has been done on the effect of these interventions for performance. That review only found a small effect size for motivational self-talk. For other content-focused approaches like imagery and relaxation, we're not aware of studies that found significant effects for performance. While trying to change thoughts and feelings doesn't reliably improve performance, shifting attention does. As you can see from this graph, separate meta-analyses on instructional self-talk, goal setting, and mental practice have shown strong, significant effects for improving athletic performance. While these three meta-analyses paid limited attention to the rigor of these included studies, with large effect sizes, we might guess that we'd at least get some benefit when using these approaches with athletes. Rather than trying to control thoughts and feelings, all three interventions seem to focus on shifting attention to things that are more likely to help improve performance. More recently, researchers have suggested another type of intervention that will help athletes perform well by focusing their attention in a specific way. Acceptance-based approaches suggest difficult thoughts and feelings are a normal part of being an athlete, and that athletes can learn to focus on the present moment regardless of those thoughts and feelings. A common acceptance-based approach is mindfulness, which hopes to help people develop non-judgmental awareness of the present moment. Put another way, athletes can learn to have anxiety or an unhelpful thought without judging it or changing it, and then redirect their focus back to what they're doing. Our review aimed to summarize all of the studies on these mindfulness and acceptance approaches so far. After looking through over 5,000 titles and over 100 full texts, we found 66 studies on mindfulness and acceptance approaches in athletes. Some studies have found that the interventions significantly increase present moment awareness, increase flow, they help performance, and they also help reduce anxiety. There's preliminary evidence that these interventions might prevent injuries, reduce burnout, and increase confidence. Similarly, the correlational studies found that more mindful athletes tend to be more mentally tough, more motivated, and more confident, amongst other things. So on one hand, if you're trying to improve performance, you could do worse than trying to include mindfulness alongside other attentional control strategies. On the other hand, there's a consistent set of problems with the studies that researchers may want to address in the future. The internal validity of these studies make it hard to draw causal claims about the effects of these interventions. So for example, we found 17 randomized controlled trials, but none of them met the Cochrane criteria for low risk of bias. These criteria include good reporting of randomization, blinding of the key people in the study, good management of data when participants drop out, and full reporting of the outcomes presented in the protocol. Some people think that it's almost impossible to meet these standards in sports psychology research, but we disagree. For example, registering a protocol in advance is one of the steps that reduces bias. Doing this requires no cost, but instead just requires a culture change where researchers declare what they're going to do before they do it. Likewise, reporting who randomized people into groups and how they did it is a free, effective way of increasing transparency. Studies that use reporting checklists like Consort will already tick many of these boxes, but our findings suggest that these tools have not been well used in the mindfulness and acceptance literature. So, we think there's a broader message from our review, one which reviewers have been reminding us of for years. If we want to be able to make causal claims about any of the interventions we test in sports psychology, our claims will be stronger if we carefully consider ways of increasing internal validity. Mindfulness and acceptance approaches may improve performance, and they may have a wide range of other benefits, but we need registered, blinded, randomized trials for us to know it for sure. For more information about why these approaches might work and how we can better test them, take a look at the full article. We hope you find it valuable.